welcome to Coffeyville Community College for our volleyball game against the Greyhounds from Port Scott Community College. Before we get started, we'd like to take a moment and recognize our sophomores this evening. First, for the Port Scott Greyhounds, number 3, Bailey Morgan. Number 4, Brittany Bailey. Number 5, Claudia Ariyak. And number 7, Addison Lyons. And now let's meet the Red Raven sophomores. Ladies and gentlemen, from Atillo, Puerto Rico, number 2, libero, Paola Molina. CCC are to finish her biology degree and keep playing volleyball. Paola's best memories while here at CCC have been the opportunities to meet and create tremendous friendships with those around her. Paola would like to thank her family and Coach Dockley for all the support. Number 2, Paola Molina. From Independence, Kansas, number 3, defensive specialist, Chloe Mills. Chloe is being escorted by her mother, Helen
Mills.
After CCC, Chloe plans on attending Kansas State University to become a dietitian. A couple of Chloe's fondest memories while at CCC were the stay at the 5-star hotel in Iowa and team bonding while making TikToks. Chloe wishes to add thank yous to my coach and family for always supporting me and helping me reach the next point in my life. Number 3, Chloe Mills. From Independence, Kansas, number 4, setter Kaylee Bully. Kaylee is being escorted by her parents, Bob and Lorana Bully. Kaylee's plans after CCC is to continue her education at a university and major in communication sciences and disorders. Some of Kaylee's fondest memories have been weekly Monday night dinners at El Charo's with teammates. Kaylee would like to thank her parents and sister for always supporting her, and to coach for her time, dedication, and guidance to her and this team. Number 4, Kaylee Bowling. From Tulsa, Oklahoma, number 5, middle blocker, Hannah Armstrong. Hannah is being escorted by Melissa and Dion Armstrong. Hannah's plans after CCC is to attend Oklahoma State University and pursue a degree in marketing. One of Hannah's fondest memories while at CCC was the rescuing of a stray cat and letting it live in her and Heather's house with her and Heather's house in their dorm room without anybody finding out. And Hannah states the following: I would like to thank my parents for endless love and support throughout my volleyball career, as well as my other family members and friends who have always been on the sidelines cheering me on. Number 5, Hannah Armstrong. From Coweta, Oklahoma, number 6, setter Heather Stiles. Heather is being escorted by Andrew Stiles, Tiffany Stiles, and Casey Stiles. After CCC, Heather plans to go to Oklahoma State University and major in kinesiology. One of Heather's fondest memories is the recovery, the rescuing of the cat last year, and having it live with them in the dorm.
Study of movement.
Heather Stiles would like to say, I want to thank you to my friend. I want to say thank you to my family for always supporting me through everything, all of my decisions. Number 6, Heather Stiles. Carolina, Puerto Rico. Number 7, setter, Rosie Gomez. Rosie is being escorted by Daniel Gomez, Iago Diaz, Alex Mihalo, and Pedro Ronco. After CCC, Rosie wants to keep playing volleyball at the next level and pursue a degree in criminal justice. Rosie's best memories is simply meeting new people and making good friends. Rosie would like to extend a very heartfelt thank you to her family and coach. Number 7, Rosie Colome. From Parsons, Kansas, number 10, right side hitter, Brianna Bedore. By her parents, Kelly and Todd Bedore. After CCC, Brianna plans on obtaining her insurance licenses once the semester is over and finishing her degree online. One of Brianna's fondest memories has been convincing the students of CCC that Hannah Armstrong and her are twins. Brianna would like to say the following thank yous to my parents, Todd and Kelly Bedore, as well as Brooke and Andy Hopper, for always supporting me and pushing me to be the best version of myself. Also, Coach Gockley, for giving me the chance to come back to play the sport that I love. Lastly, thank you to my teammates for giving me a memorable season. I love you all. Number 10, Brianna Bedore. Woo! From Florida, Puerto Rico, number 21, outside hitter, Yashica Reyes. Yashica is being escorted by her mother, Jessie. After CCC, Yashica plans are to transfer to a four-year university to continue her volleyball career while finishing her degree in environmental science. Some of Yashica's best memories are when she got to meet new people with different cultures the first days she came to Coffeyville. Yashica would like to say the following. Thanks to Coach Gockley for giving me this amazing opportunity and safety, and my family for always supporting me. Number 21, Yashica Reyes.
Yashica!
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 Ladies and gentlemen, one final time and together for our 2021-22 Coffeyville Red Raven sophomore. Woo!
Man, so as far as you've called me.
Yeah.
Okay. What do you want me to do?
Just help me do guest commentary.
Well, as far as Well, you know, like traditionally, there's usually one person that does like most of the talking, like most of the description, and then like the other person will kind of come in once they're done and be like, yeah, that was a great hit by da 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 da, and then somebody goes, oh yeah, that was a great hit. So I mean, if this is your deal here, man. I don't want to take,
oh, no.
You know.
I want you to come here personally because
okay.
I would think it was an answer.
Okay. Well, yeah, man. We'll just have some fun. Man.
Oh yeah. Okay. And what I used to do up here by myself.
Perfect, buddy. Yeah, they don't have a really big team, man.
Yeah.
They're limited.
My mom really just told me that I should be quiet. She can hear me on the feed. I'm like, so neat.
Ladies and gentlemen, please scan and remove your headwear for the playing of the national anthem.
saw that. I felt that too.
Dang.
Yes. I saw that and I felt that.
And now, tonight's starting lineup. First, for the Greyhounds of Fort Scott. From Azteca, New Mexico, number one, Carly Smith. From Missouri City, Texas, number two, Jasmine Okafor. From Fairgrove, Missouri, number three, Bailey Morgan. From Houston, Texas, number five, Claudia Ariadne. From Coweta, Oklahoma, number six, Casey Scott. From Fort Scott, Kansas, number seven, Addison Lyon. And libero this evening for the Greyhounds, number 13, Mariah Hess. Head coach of the Greyhounds is Aaliyah Diggenbaugh. And now the starting lineup for the Red Ravens. Nicole Soto. From Parsons, Kansas. Number 10, Brianna Bedore. From Valley Center, Kansas. Number 14, Kylie Glasson. And from Florida, Puerto Rico. Number 21, Yashika Reyes. Molina. The rest of the Red Ravens. Number three, Chloe Mills. Number four, Kelly Cole. Number seven, Rosie Colonna. Number 13, we're in
there. There you go. Yeah.
The coach of the Red Ravens is Katrina.
Is that better? Okay.
Good evening, Red Raven fans. We are live here on campus. What a great atmosphere we have tonight for sophomore night. My name's Dirk Andrews. With me to my right-hand side
is your one and only Stephen Kyler here.
The one and only. If you try to find another one, you just simply won't find another one. But, Stephen, we have an excellent game tonight versus the Fort Scott Greyhounds. And, again, this is sophomore night.
Mm-hmm. Sophomore night, which we have a lot of sophomores here on Coffeyville. We have around eight players that are sophomores.
You are exactly correct. So eight sophomores honored tonight, which is a very cool thing. Their families get to come. Their friends get to recognize them as well. But, you know, all celebrations aside, there's still a game to play tonight.
Oh, yeah.
They got to stay focused.
All that matters is that both teams play well and that we get to have fun watching up here.
Yeah, that's a really good point. Up here in the – is there a nickname for this? Are we in the crow's nest? Is that what this is? Or
I think maybe, yeah.
Okay, well, we're up here in the crow's nest high above with our bird's eye view. We can go ahead and call out who we see on the court. Number five, Hannah Armstrong. She is one of the sophomores tonight. Who else do we see, Stephen?
We see Brianna Bedore, number 10, who is right there.
She's a sophomore.
Yep. Along with we have Heather Stiles as well, whose sister is playing on Fort Scott's
That's
team.
Crazy, isn't it?
Very
it
cool.
Is. Yeah.
A little sisterly rivalry going on over here.
And so Yashika Reyes is out there, Kylie Dawson, and Paola Molina will get us started with the serve. Here we go, folks. Let's get it on. Dug out by Fort Scott. And it will be point Fort Scott. They'll take the first one there.
Making it 1-0 for Fort Scott. And we have a substitution. Stiles goes out for Fort Scott, and number four is subbed in.
It's kind of cool that we know someone else from the other team.
Yeah.
So Fort Scott up 1-0. They will be serving here. Dug out by Molina.
and spiked down by Hannah Armstrong.
And there we have it, 1-1 score for the Red Ravens. Hannah Armstrong, a sophomore, one of the leaders on this team.
Yep, she's mainly been generating most of the points, about 3.8 kills per game, which technically means that she's leading in the kills category.
I expect more from her tonight, as well as we see some good team play here. Yashka.
Way to go by Yashka Reyes.
Nice. Another sophomore, number 21, gives the lead back to the Red Ravens. And it'll be Kylie Dawson back to serve. Wow, what an atmosphere already, man. This is
cool.
Oh,
yeah. Full capacity almost.
Yeah.
Our fans over here are just chatting it up and
exactly.
Having fun.
Fort Scott works it around, and oh, that'll be in.
Hit by number two, Jasmine Okafor.
Really good hit by her. Nice placement. Mm-hmm. Nothing really the Red Raven players could do there. Substitution in number three, Chloe Mills, another sophomore from Independence, Kansas. Fort Scott up, and it's dug out there. Set in.
Hits the roof of that one.
Back over to the Red Ravens.
Set up by Heather.
Spike doors
up. Over by Brianna.
Ooh, clever play, but Fort Scott there for that one. Oh, good hustle there from Chloe Mills, but Fort Scott will take that point there. 2-3 in favor of the Greyhounds. Chloe Mills, nice hustle, but just wasn't able to get it over.
We have a pretty good hustle on our team, and as you could see over there by Chloe, but we also have a good – they also have good hitters over here on the other side. Yeah,
that is true, and so that point will go over to the Greyhounds. Three consecutive points for them so far.
Making it four Greyhounds and then two Coffeyville.
Dug out by Chloe Mills, set, and there's Armstrong. Oh, that'll stay in.
What good trick.
Clever play right there. Number six, Heather Stiles. I wonder if Sister Casey's impressed by that move right there. Very good. Serve back over to the Red Ravens. This will be Kaylee Bolig, sophomore from Independence. Rosie Colomé is in as well.
See, I could never pronounce her last name right. I always said Cologne.
Well,
like Cologne.
I might be doing it wrong, but there she gets a touch to it.
Hit over by Yishka.
Recovered there from Fort Scott. And that will be out. Point Red Ravens. Keeping her serve is Kaylee Bolick. I have to admit, folks, this is my first time commentating for volleyball, and no offense to soccer, but this is intense.
Oh, yeah, it gets really intense.
Wow. You guys can hear the crowd noise. Spike from Fort Scott, dug by. Wow, nice job by Chloe.
Good play by Nicole. Oh, no, it's Hannah.
Dang, that was nice dig there from Chloe. Able to keep the ball alive. Hannah with the hammer.
She hits like a hammer, I'll tell you that.
What? 5-4, Red Ravens retake the lead. Dug out by Fort Scott. Just gets it over. Paola sets it up. Hannah.
Oh! Scott Sterling moment right there.
That was a facial.
Ugh.
And she didn't even have to pay for that one. That was a free one.
Ooh. Oh, yeah.
Hannah Armstrong laying down the hammer. So Kaylee Bolig continues to serve with a 6-4 lead.
That's my dream height right there, 6-4.
Ball is up. Cross court. Just a tip there from the blockers, and nothing can be done. Point over to Fort Scott, 6-5. Fort Scott down 1 point.
And speaking of Kaylee Bolig, she is actually second in assists per game.
Nice.
Which I think is pretty good.
Yeah, very impressive. And also impressive right there, Hannah Armstrong. Oh, I think she touched the net. So that point will not be given to the Red Ravens. That will be given to Fort Scott. I don't know if you are familiar with a guy named Air Michael Jordan, but Hannah Armstrong had some hang time right
there.
She
does, yeah. I'd like to see her in a dunk contest one of these
days. She could probably get it done. Here's a set, cross court, Yashka.
Good. Oh. Way to go.
And you can see Rosie's non-verbals there, the kind of slam down type Oh, that was a good one. And so we now see number five, Hannah Armstrong, 7-6 lead for the Red Ravens. Ooh, solid serve there.
Set up for Rosie. Rosie hits it over.
Oh, okay. Rosie with the point. All right.
And she's only a freshman.
They're having some fun tonight, both the players and the students.
You can hear them chanting Rosie down there.
That is awesome. 8-6 to the Red Ravens. Hannah Armstrong still serving. Dug out by Fort Scott. Nothing going there, my friend. That'll be point to the Red Ravens.
I feel like whenever it goes up to the ceiling and it comes down at a weird angle, so that way they have to like adjust their hit.
You got to be really skilled and focused to be able to play it like that. Nicole Soto, number 9, did a good job of securing that one there. And just not enough mustard onto that one there. Hannah Armstrong will go out.
And so will number 4 for Fort Scott. And coming in is Heather Stiles' sister, Casey Stiles.
It's so crazy, man. Still really cool. I bet this is a very cool experience for her parents as well.
Set up for Nicole Soto.
Oh, nice dig there from Fort Scott. Sets it up for Nicole.
And Nicole actually is at second with 2.1 kills per game.
Looking for her first one here. Block. And nice hustle there from Fort Scott, but not enough to keep that point. Point Red Ravens, 10-7 lead.
And Kylie Dawson is subbed in for Chloe Mills. Yeah, that's it.
And Yeshka Reyes, one of the sophomores, she'll be serving. She's got a wonderful serve. I love
she
to
does.
Watch her play. Oh, wow, look at that, giving them trouble.
Oh, hit over the four hits, and they are only allowed to hit three.
You only get three, my friend. You only get three of those hits, and timeout on the floor for Fort Scott. And we will take a short break ourselves. All right, and we are back. Yeshka Reyes will be serving. Quick timeout for Fort Scott there, trying to regroup. 11-7. Steven, let's get it on.
Right on, man.
Nice serve there, dug out by Fort Scott.
Good attempt to block out there by both Kylie and Nicole, but it just slightly gets over.
Carly Smith, number 1 from Fort Scott, really did a good job of placing that and having enough power as well.
Number 2 for Fort Scott, a sub back in for number 1.
And this will be number 13, Mariah Hess on the serve.
LeBaron. Good save there by Paola.
Interesting ball. Almost a kill for Soto.
Oh, yeah.
Rosie's up.
Here we go.
Rosie makes the score 12-8, Red Ravens. The crowd likes it, I think.
The crowd is going bananas for Rosie however you say her last name.
And this will be
Heather Stiles.
Stiles versus Stiles here. Let's see if she goes right at her sister. Oh, I was hoping she would. Yeah. Good block there. Good dig, and this will set up for Bedore. Bedore.
Good save by Heather, though.
Yeah, excellent job. Follows up, and Molina gets to that one.
Kylie Dawson just out of bounds, just barely.
Just a little too far on that one there. Needs to maybe get over the top of that one, but really good gameplay there from both sides. Good job by the Ravens to work it around. 12-9, Red Ravens.
Nicole. Ooh. Almost with a kill again.
Yeah, that was set up nicely. Ooh, good job by Kylie Dawson. Okay.
On top of the lights.
Oh, wow, that's so tough. Such a tough ball.
Oh, the fans do not like that call.
So we're going to get a net interference there, I think. Point over to the Greyhounds. Man, each point is so intense. 12-10, Fort Scott.
Welcome to volleyball, Dirk.
Seriously, this is awesome.
Just wait until basketball season starts then, and it'll get really crazy.
That's true, and a really great block there from Fort Scott, and point will go over to the Greyhounds, 12-11.
Catching back up here, and it's been so far pretty good for Greyhounds.
Yes, it has. It's really been an even match so far. Both teams going on small runs. Yashka's going to dig that one out. There we go. Nice job. Set up by Stiles. Put away by Soto.
And now Hannah Armstrong back in.
It's good to have her back in as Molina will be serving. 13-11, Red Raven lead. Ball is up, dug out by Fort Scott. Ooh, looked like that was going to be a big hit right there.
Oh, yeah.
Right into the net, so point Red Ravens, 14-11.
Right now, their record is for Fort Scott is 7-20.
Okay.
And Coffeyville's is 17-20.
I wonder if they had maybe had to cancel some games because of COVID. But, wow, really good serve there. Just kept alive, and Hannah Armstrong, whoa.
Jeez.
And that's going to be tough for Fort Scott to play, and point Red Ravens.
It's definitely going to be tough to play that whenever you're getting, whenever the ball is coming at you by Hannah Armstrong.
That's true. That's true, yeah.
And her arm is strong indeed.
Yes, it is. So Molina will be serving once again, 15-11 lead here. And that will be an ace. Nice job by
Way
Molina. What great placement right there. And Fort Scott feeling the heat. Red Ravens on a little run here. They're going to go ahead and take another timeout on the floor.
And we'll be right back after this for more CCC volleyball.
All right, back for some more action. 16-11 lead for the Red Ravens. Molina will be serving. Steven, this has been a great one so far.
Oh, yeah.
And more greatness to come. Serve is up.
And good.
Cross court. There's a dig there from Stiles. Molina puts it up. Dawson.
A good save by Dawson.
Okay, nice reflexes there. Bedour puts it up. Good block. Molina to Dawson. Oh, wow, that was weird.
That was weird.
Interesting.
It was like a basketball rolling on the rim there. Like, you don't know if it's going to go in or out.
Exactly. I didn't know if it was going to go on our side or the other. But, hey, this has been a nice little run for the Red Ravens, 17-11. Molina still serving.
Molina has a good serve. Also like Hannah Armstrong. Ooh.
Oh, that was a really big hit there from Fort Scott. They needed that to get back into this match here. But, no, I agree. Molina, and the thing about her is she switches up her serves too.
Yeah.
So sometimes it could be fast, a knuckleball, but not quite sure what the discussion is here. Oh, okay, just getting the ball out. Looks like for Fort Scott it'll be number 5, Claudia serving.
And Heather Stiles' sister is now subbed out, and I think number four came in for.
Okay. Ooh, nice block there from Fort Scott.
Good recovery, though, by Paola.
True, true. Good job by Kylie.
See the teamwork right there. They're like bread and butter. Or Batman and Robin.
Shake and bake. Either way, that's a point for the Red Ravens, inching closer to that 25-point goal, 18-12. This will be Chloe Mills, number three from Independence, coming in to serve. Oh, nice block there.
By Hannah Armstrong.
Dang, that was big right there. That block. What great reflexes there. That's 19-12 for the Red Ravens. Hannah Armstrong.
She's a one-man wrecking crew for this team, I'm telling you.
Oh, just a real bad.
Tried kicking a goal there.
Yeah, and she almost did. But number four there, you can't really blame her. She was kind of in between, you know. Do I underhand it? Do I overhand it? Just a really good serve there from Mills. 20-12, Red Ravens. Playable ball for the Red Ravens up and. Oh, really good effort there from Fort Scott, but ultimately not enough. 21-12. Hammer and Hannah Armstrong. She might get mad at me for giving her that nickname, but she can come talk to me if she wants to. Hammer and Hannah. That's, man, she always does a really good job. Chloe Mills.
Or I'm actually going to call her Arm and Hammer.
There you go. Up and, oh, good hustle.
Oh, good hustle there by Fort Scott as well.
Both sides.
Oh, my.
Oh, wow.
That's like a behind-the-back pass on a basketball game right
Seriously.
There.
Seriously. Yeah, that's like a no-look. Fooled you. Whoa, Heather Stiles, what an excellent point. 22-12, Red Ravens in a commanding lead. Chloe Mills just unable to get to that one. Fort Scott with the point there, 22-13.
And LeBaron is subbed out, and number one comes back in for Fort Scott as well.
Number two, Jasmine, will be serving. Dug out by Mills, set up by Stiles and Yashka.
Set up for number seven and hits it over just with a gentle tap of the fingers.
Oh, good reaction there. Big hit. Wow. Got to give Molina credit for just being able to get a fist onto that one.
And for Chloe there, for trying to dive into the swimming pool there.
And there is not a swimming pool down there. There's just hard stands and fans. So good hustle all around. 22-14.
Oh, my.
Yeah. It's a work of art when you can get Hannah moving to her right side, but then she spikes it back to her left. It's so awesome to watch. 23-14, Kaylee Bolig will come in to serve.
Another Independence native.
Yeah, just down the road.
Oh, yeah. And also not too far from Caney as well.
That's true. The whole area here. We welcome them all, and serve is up.
Tried to float it on over. Stayed on our side of the net.
Timing just a little off right there, but you can see what they were trying to do there. That momentum moving her forward if the ball would have been placed well. But so 23-15, Red Ravens still lead.
Set up for Yashka. Yashka hits it on over successfully. Good blocks.
Oh, wow. Very good. Hannah Armstrong and Rosie. There for the block, 24-15, and let's have it here, Hannah. Let's go ahead and finish this set out.
And we now have the two tallest players on Coffeyville out there on the floor right now. Nicole standing at 6 foot tall.
And that was called for the Red Ravens. That's an ace, and that will do it. First set is done. Coffeyville takes the first one, 25-15.
And we'll be right back for more CCC Volleyball.
tell you about it. It's great out here.
We'll find out whenever someone either trips on the water. I mean, look at the roof. I mean, it certainly ain't no. You just take the wheel. Breaking the flood at Yale Hall.
And here we are back at the campus of Coffeyville Community College. First set goes to the Red Ravens. Steven, what did you notice in that first set?
I noticed a lot of things. Good teamwork there for Coffeyville. Good hustle by Fort Scott. And one hilarious face hit.
Hilarious for us, but maybe not for the player.
Yeah.
But I imagine, though, if you play volleyball for long enough, I mean, you're probably going to encounter something
like that. You're definitely going to get used to it.
Yeah, it's almost like if you play basketball for long enough, you're going to get blocked. You know what I mean? Like your shot's going to be blocked. Or
get dunked on.
Yeah,
knowing me.
If you're a soccer player and you play goalie, yeah, you're going to get scored on. You know what I mean? But, yeah, that first set, very intense, not only from the players but also from the fans here at CCC. Awesome atmosphere overall. Hannah Armstrong stood out to me that first set.
Oh, yeah.
Soto as well in the middle. But really the whole team just working around, you know, communicating with each other. Katrina Gockley, head coach, has to be happy with that.
Oh, yeah, definitely, because this is her second season or her second year here with Coffeyville. And I think her assistant coach is Kaylee Matthews. I bet they're having a ball over there.
Yeah, I think so. You know, not only are they playing well, but it's sophomore night. You know, parents are here. It's a celebration overall.
Oh, yeah.
But you don't want to just do half the job, right? You want to go ahead and get the victory as well. But yeah, Coach Gockley, second year season, right? Because last year they played in the spring, but second season here at CCC. I think she's done a great job, not only for the team but also on campus as well. She teaches a couple classes.
Really?
So it's pretty cool. Yeah, she coaches and she teaches classes as well. So that's an awesome combo. As looks like for this second set, Fort Scott will be serving. It'll be Mariah Hess. And I think she has switched out of the libero shirt.
Yep,
and Casey Stiles will be in.
And Zella Bennett is now on the floor for Coffeyville.
Oh, wow. There we go.
It almost looked like it was on the line there, but they called it out of bounds.
Okay, yeah. I definitely misinterpreted that one as it was close, but...
Close, but no cigar.
Yeah, close, but no cigar. And, yeah, that'll go over to Fort Scott. So they lead this second set 1-0.
And that's got to give them a lot of momentum there at the start of this game.
Yeah, you're right. And they need that probably. They need that momentum. Yashka up
Yashka
and good.
Reyes.
Okay.
Have a little bit of Spud Webb hops right there.
Seriously, a lot of hang time there, a lot of power on that ball. It looks like who do we have new into the match? Number 11,
Zella Bennett.
Yeah, Zella Bennett.
She is the second tallest player, right after Hannah Armstrong.
Okay, she is new into the match.
Both 6'1". Man, if I was 6'1", I'd be doing a lot more.
Oh, wow! Really nice kill right there. Number 4, Brittley Bailey for Fort Scott.
6'1" sophomore hailing from Girard, Kansas.
Wow. And I think if she's not left-handed, then she's ambidextrous because that left arm right there did a lot of
damage.
Yeah, did a lot of damage. So good for them. Good for Fort Scott. A little momentum, like you said. 1-2, Fort Scott leads. Dawson digs this one out. Oh, and that was close as well.
Yeah, the flag person over here didn't really know what to do because it looked very good. But, of According to them, it was out of bounds.
Yeah,
so.
According to them, it was. And Armstrong also had a look on her face like she thought that was good to go. But nonetheless, 3-1 lead for Fort Scott. They've come out hot this second set.
Good hustle there by Stiles on the other side. Mm-hmm.
The other Stiles. Ball is up.
Yeah.
And Bennett.
We haven't seen a lot of Zella Bennett much, but I've seen her play before, and she's a pretty good player.
They're going to need her right now as Fort Scott goes on a little bit of a run here. 4-1 Fort Scott. Kylie Dawson tried to play that one, but it was just too hot to handle.
Yeah, oh, yeah, definitely.
She'll get to this one. Ah, just
a little bit of a early reaction time there, but good reaction time for number two out there. Jasmine Okrafor.
Yeah, and it was as if they kind of already knew what she was doing there. They were able to block that easily. Hannah will think differently about that next time. Alina digs this one out. Over to Armstrong.
Oh, yeah.
Different side, different result. There we go.
Because I think mainly their strategy is just get the ball to either Hannah or Heather or according to the fans, Rosie.
Yeah, Rosie let her do some things as well.
Oh, yeah.
And she had a really good first set as we see number four, Kaylee Bullock, come in. She's going to serve this one up.
Good save over there. Way to almost run into that person over there on the bench.
Yeah, Rosie, good job to keep it alive as well.
Woo! Almost hit the air conditioning bench.
It's a really hard ball to handle right there for Paola as that point will go to the Greyhounds, 6-2. And, yeah, this second set is really calling out the Red Ravens here. They're going to have to come back here. And for the Red Ravens, it seems like a lot of unforced errors as well. You know, little things that just isn't happening for them now. But
like that, like this last one we just had, I mean, they would have been really close to the net there, and it would have been their point anyway for net interference.
Let's see what they can do here up to Rosie. Rosie blocked right in her spot.
Yep.
8-2 Greyhounds, and Red Ravens will go ahead and take a timeout, try to stop this momentum, try to stop this run. We'll take a break as well.
And we'll be right back for more CCC Volleyball. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. We are back here at Nellis Hall, home of the Red Ravens. I'm Stephen Kyler. Alongside me is the one and only Dirk Matthews. Did I say your last name right? Because I think it's Matthews.
Andrews,
okay. I don't know why I was thinking Matthews.
Oh, it's all good, man. Rosie puts this one over. Red Ravens need to do something here, Stephen.
Oh, yeah. They need a good thing they took all the time out to regroup and re-strategize as well. Hits the top of the pole there, making it CCC's point, making it 3-8.
That's honestly something that they needed right there. They needed a little bit of
momentum.
Luck. Yeah, momentum to shift in their way, maybe a little bit of luck as well. These next couple of serves are going to be big. No better person to do it than Hannah Armstrong.
Literally big.
Let's get it here.
Oh, it just almost goes over, but just hits the top of the net.
Yeah, and that's tough there because that's going to give the Greyhounds a 9-3 lead. Not insurmountable, but yet every point just Red Ravens digging themselves a deeper hole here. For Fort Scott, Brittley Bailey's going to serve this one up left-handed. Molina digs this one, and Soto's up.
Soto.
Good hustle there from Stiles, the other Stiles. Just a little miss hit there from Soto, and that's going to give the point to the Greyhounds.
3-10 right now at the second set.
Red Ravens a little stunned here. Who's going to be the player to bring him out of this?
Probably either Hannah or Noah and Brianna. Could possibly – it could be any one of these girls.
It's going to have to be someone there. Is another point over to the Greyhounds, 11-3. Oh, nice.
I also looked like it kind of hit the ground there first, but according to them, it didn't hit the ground.
And Bador puts this one over. Oh, really good placement there. That was number five for Fort Scott, Claudia. That's, wow, really good placement.
And for 5'7", she had some really good hang time there.
Yes, she did.
Now, Yishka Reyes is coming back in for Coffeyville.
Man, that could be a really good thing there. We need her intensity and spirit here.
And I notice this on the court sometimes, but anytime that she's on the court, she usually smiles. And it's like that positive energy that gets the team all riled up, you know?
That's true. And here we see the Greyhounds taking a 10-point lead, 13-3. It's a tell of two matches so far.
Oh, yeah.
First set, all Red Ravens. Second set so far, all Greyhounds. Dug out by Molina.
Over by Bedore. Good play by Bedore.
That's what we needed right there, Stevens. That's what we needed right there. So 4-13. Chloe Mills is going to come in to serve
for Brianna Bedore.
Let's see if we can keep this possession here, keep our serve, and try to dig into that lead from the Greyhounds.
Oh, you have both Indy players in right now, which is good for them too, because they played with each other before.
That's a really good point. An unforced error there from Fort Scott, going to give the point to the Red Ravens. And at this moment, you'll just take them when and where you can.
And however.
Yeah, so 5-13, Fort Scott leads.
Oh, they did a play out of our book while Paola does a little somersault.
Yeah, a little taste of our own medicine there. Just a really clever move to kind of throw the defense off a little bit and just go ahead and put it back over Ned. And 14-5, Greyhounds. Good job by Paola.
Hit over by Yishka, who is third on scoring with 1.36 kills per game.
Excellent block there from Rosie and Nicole.
Spiked from the back row. Rosie with a hit, but successfully defended there by Fort Scott.
Tipped by the Red Ravens and falling inbounds. That will make the score 15-5, Greyhounds.
Double-digit lead for Fort Scott, but hopefully we can make a comeback. I've seen it happen before.
Yeah, and if not a comeback, some sort of momentum shift as Nicole puts this one over. Oh, nice move there. Cross court, Yashka puts it up. Oh, clever move there, and
a little miscommunication there for Coffeyville, and very well communication over there for Fort Scott.
Another timeout on the floor for the Red Ravens. Going to try to stop the bleeding just a little bit here. We'll be right back
for more of your CCC Volleyball.
Five lead for Fort Scott. Timeout taken by Coach Gockley here. Interesting to see how they respond overall. Serving for Fort Scott, number three, Bailey Morgan. Soto tries to get that one over. Molina digs it. Yishka
hit
up.
By Yishka, good hit over, but saved up by the other Styles. Oh, blocked by Soto.
There we go. That's what we need right there.
Soto ain't going to take it no mo.
Exactly. Number nine, Nicole Soto out of Wichita.
And now Heather Styles is back in, or as I call her, the sharer, because she likes to share the ball with every single teammate.
There you go. Yeah, she's the assist person in. Oh, misplayed there from Fort Scott, but kept alive.
Good teamwork there by Fort Scott there to, like, try to regroup on that one.
That's true. Nice dig from Chloe.
Oh, Heather tried to trick out her own sister.
Yeah.
Didn't work that time. Oh,
wow.
Man, she is all over the place.
Yes, she is.
Way
point
to go there.
Red Ravens.
Zella Bennett and Nicole Soto on that one right there.
Yeah, good job by them to team up and block that one. And
especially with their height.
Is Styles going to go to her sister on this one?
Oh,
let's see. Oh, okay.
Oh, just almost. Way to stay in the back row there to keep that ball alive.
Yeska tried to finesse that one over. Maybe she needed to come with some power on that one. That point will go to Fort Scott. Yep. 17-7, still a double-digit lead. Chloe Mills gets this one up. Bennett. Hit. And even though Fort Scott, well, hold on now. I thought that.
It looked like it didn't. It looked like they hit it.
Well, and so, yeah, that must have been point Fort Scott, which another point for Fort Scott. 19-7. Yeah, that the one before, the play before.
Yeah.
Something happened there.
Oh, yeah.
Fort Scott, they were happy, but then our announcer said, but, yeah, that's long gone now.
Yep.
Oh.
Oh, she gave it like a little leprechaun.
That was an ace there from Fort Scott, and 20-7 is the score, 25 for the set.
Let's see if Casey hit. Oh, she almost hit it. She almost hit it to her sister, but went to the back row instead.
Good hustle, and here we go.
Good save by Paola.
And we'll take that right there. Zella Bennett just puts it where it needs to go. 20-8 for the Red Ravens. Hannah Armstrong back in and Molina to serve.
Never underestimate Zella Bennett because she can play anywhere.
Good point. Good observation, my friend, as Fort Scott tries to play this one over, and they will.
Set up by Heather and hit by Yushka.
Ooh.
Tried to dive into the swimming pool, but just barely missed the diving board.
Hannah Armstrong tries for the kill there.
Yushka again.
Oh, another good dig from Fort Scott.
Number two for Fort Scott is just getting kills left and right.
Good job by them, and the score is 21-8.
I think Fort Scott may have this set won.
Yeah, I do too, man. I never want to count any Red Raven team out.
Oh,
but
yeah.
You lose the battle, but you're trying to live the war, or trying to win the war overall. Really good serve there.
And good hustle by Paola. Oh, good move by Hannah Armstrong.
Excellent digs from Styles.
No one was in the middle there. A little bit of miscommunication. Because that's, I think, what volleyball really needs more of, is like the team to really communicate on the floor and find a specific way to make the other team off a little bit off their game, if you get the pun.
And so here we go, 22-8, Fort Scott serving. Hannah's up.
Dang!
Oh, wow, nice dig from Fort Scott.
Oh, so I was going to take her head off.
Another good dig from Fort Scott. They're able to handle those
out of bounds
balls
there.
And that will be point for the Red Ravens, a big one, but will it amount to much? 22-9.
And Brianna Bedore subbed in for Chloe Mills.
Yeshka Reyes will be serving.
Yeshka is really good at serving. You could just put her about anywhere, and she can just play well.
That's true. She's got volleyball in her veins, that's for
oh,
sure.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, nice block.
And then she saved it with like a weird like shrug.
Yeah, that was good by her. In the middle for Hannah, and
dang,
it's a kill. There we go.
See, Heather and Hannah, they are a well-oiled machine.
H&H, that's what we need right there. We need some more of those. 22-10, Red Ravens, are we mounting a comeback?
I think any time that Yushka is serving, they gain momentum a little because they know that they can depend on her, but that time the momentum is going over to Fort Scott.
Yeah, she tried to really pinpoint that one into the corner there, and 23-10 is the score. Kylie Dawson comes in, number 14.
hip to Paola, or Paola, or however you say it. Oh!
Oh, man, great block by number two, Jasmine, for Fort Scott. Wow.
Now we have a little bit of a conversation going on between the official on the top and the and number two.
Yeah, the one who actually did the blocking there. We will have a set point here, 24-10.
Oh, trick play.
Wow.
But her sister knew her game.
And there it is, folks. Set two goes to Fort Scott. So set one to CCC, set two to Fort Scott. It'll be really interesting to see who comes out for this third set. Let's take a break and come back with some action.
We'll be right back for more Red Ravens volleyball after this. Hola, senores and senoritas. Hello, boys and girls of all ages. Welcome back to CCC Volleyball here at Nellis Hall. I'm your announcer, Steven Kyler, here alongside me with the man, the myth, the legend, Dirk Andrews. How are you doing so far, Dirk? What do you think?
I'm actually very happy, you know, delighted.
Yeah.
To be here. You guys invited me up into the booth. That's a very cool thing. And again, no offense to soccer, but wow, I'm having a lot of fun doing volleyball. A lot of action back and forth. It's fast pace. I'm not even playing, but I'm sweating. I think I've lost a couple pounds up here in the crow's nest hanging out with you guys. But my question is, who is going to grab the early points in this set? You know what I mean? It seems like whoever grabs the early points, you know, sets the tone and finishes out usually as the victor. CCC was able to grab the points early in the first set, Fort Scott in the second. Styles for Fort Scott as the libero seem to work out very well for them. So it looks like they're going to stick with that. Number two, Jasmine for Fort Scott as well. She's doing a really good job. Looks like the Red Ravens will be –
getting the first serve here.
First serve.
And it's going to Paola Molina.
Yeah, and again, we need to have some really good serves early. We need to have good communication, like you said. Oh, wow. Wow. That thing was moving.
Yep, that thing was flying, and no one could see it coming.
Well, and not only that, but I think it had like a knuckle or a little bit of a dip. But either way, 1-0 to the Red Ravens. Paola with a great ace right there. Oh, man.
Just hits the net right that one.
You can see what she was going for, too.
Yeah.
She was kind of trying to throw him off with a serve over to the left-hand side, but ultimately will not work out. And here we are, 1-1.
Anything can happen so far in the third set.
This is a big set for sure, man.
It's
big transition set right here. Up and oh, wow.
What a floater. Almost like a floater and a serve at the same time.
A knuckle float?
Yeah.
Like a knuckle floater?
Yeah.
A floater knuckle? Or either way, called out the Red Raven team, and they're going to have to do better with that there. They got to be more aware.
Hit over by Yushka.
Good dig there from Styles.
For Coffeyville. No, yeah, not the one from Fort Scott.
The Coffeyville Styles, yeah.
Coffeyville style.
Oh, yeah, that's a really good ball there from Fort Scott. Really good placement. They've done a really good job tonight on placing their balls, placing them exactly where, honestly, the Red Ravens just aren't overall.
And we have a little bit of an issue over there for Yushka. It looks like she may have hurt her hand of some sort.
Yeah, she's looking for some tape and, goodness gracious, hopefully that's not serious there. Hopefully she just needs to replace maybe some tape that she already had.
Probably.
What do we have here? 3-1 so far this set over to the Fort Scott Greyhounds. Steve, an interesting time of year here in the United States because, honestly, you have all major sporting leagues happening, going on at the same time. You have World Series in baseball.
Yep.
NBA's just getting started. NFL's in full swing.
Yep.
So if you're a fan of sports, you love this time of year for
sure.
Oh,
yeah.
And then, you know, for us here on campus, we have volleyball looking to get into the postseason. We have men and women's soccer getting into the postseason as well. Red Raven football, even though they suffered their first loss last week, still looking really good overall. So what an exciting time.
Yeah. And basketball is coming up pretty soon, too, for CCC.
Reigning national champion, so that'll be great. Fort Scott up and...
A little bit too much hammer on that by Hannah Armstrong.
Yeah, a little bit too much. She's going to want that one back, but still a really good play overall. Good pass to get it to her. Just needs a little bit better placement. So 4-1, Fort Scott Greyhounds up early in this third set. Number 13, Hess, serving.
Almost another knuckle floater right there, or whatever that was. Tried to get blocked there by Hannah, but number two there just figured out where to hit it at and how well to hit it.
Exactly. Okafor there, number two. Nice placement, nice power, and all of a sudden Red Ravens find themselves in a bit of a hole here, 5-1.
Let's hope this doesn't turn out to be like the second set.
That's true, sir. That's true.
Good save there for Brianna Bedore. And hit up to Yushka. Yushka hits it over. Number three.
Oh, man.
Oh, looked like.
So I think one of the Red Raven players hit the net, and that will be a point for Fort Scott. Can see a little bit of frustration. Yeah,
and honestly,
confusion.
Yeah.
You're exactly right. Another one of those balls up, and...
Man.
Nice dig.
These girls' arms are going to be sore tomorrow.
Yes,
I'll tell you that.
Yes, they will. This one played over.
Set up by Heather. Hit over. Number four over there didn't see that one coming.
Oh, woo! Nice block there. And that's exactly what we needed right there, Stephen. My goodness, sir. To try to cut into this deficit. 6-2. Looks like Yashka will be serving. Kylie Dawson comes in. Can we find some rhythm here? Can we get into some sort of groove here?
Let's see. Because you have both Hannah and Heather out there, the two H's, which means that they're going to work very well together.
H and H.
And then you also have Yashka who can serve it, spike it, do about anything.
Kylie gets this one over. And that one's going to be out. Yeah. Good thinking there, you know, trying to call the Red Ravens out, but just went too far, and that's exactly what the Red Ravens needed right there. Two consecutive points. Let's make it three. 6-3, Fort Scott leads. Oh, there we go.
Another block.
All right. Nice block there from Hannah Armstrong starting to gain a little bit of that confidence back, and I think that's really what the Red Ravens need. They just need a little bit of confidence going forward.
And a little bit, they definitely need some confidence, and even a little. And they even you can even see some of the smiles on their faces, which is good because positivity generates confidence.
There you go.
Which generates momentum.
Geishka up, good serve.
And the Styles for the for Fort Scott recovers it, and Dawson.
All right. There we go.
Yeah.
There we go. Kylie Dawson.
Number 14.
Yeah, 14 from Valley Center, Kansas.
I haven't seen much of her this season, but I am impressed with what I'm seeing so far. She is a very good player.
She's athletic. She can jump.
Only 5'6", and has hang time.
Another really good block by Hannah Armstrong.
Almost blocked by Hannah and Brianna. Ooh. Oh, tricked out her sister there a little bit.
Alina with the dig, and Hannah's up. That will be for the Red Ravens.
Yep.
Good block from Fort Scott, but blocked it right out of bounds. And before you know it, Steven, it goes from 2-6 to 6-6. All right, this is the run that we needed right here. Let's see if the Red Ravens can take the lead. That one's in, folks.
Yes, sir, right on the line.
Perfect.
The coach over there is like going, are you sure?
But it has been confirmed.
Oh, yeah.
And that gives the Red Ravens their first lead of this third set. I think it's their first lead at least.
Mm-hmm.
They've had four consecutive points.
Off serves, I mean.
Yep. All coming from Reyes and her serves. This one's up. Really unfortunate there for the Red Ravens. They did block, but just right into their own net. So after a really good run of play, 7-7 is the score. And Okafor, the star for Fort Scott so far, she's going to be serving.
And then you have Heather's sister, Casey, who's all, like right behind her on that, and she's been pretty good as well.
Yeah, she has. Hannah Armstrong got a really good hit on that one, but unfortunately goes out of bounds.
Yep, and good save by Kylie to find the right spot. Good play over by Brianna.
There we go. That's what I'm talking about.
Yes, sir. The Michael Jordan and Scottie Pippen.
There you go.
Or the Larry Bird and Bill Russell combo.
I like that. Yeah, and, you know, having Hannah's momentum going forward, her being able to get a nice complete jump on that ball, I mean, it's almost impossible. Number four, Kaylee Bolick coming in. Score is 8-8 Red Ravens.
And also Zella Bennett coming in too. So far you have your tallest players out there right now, 6'1", but for Zella and Hannah Armstrong. And then Yishka is, the second tallest with a 5'8".
Unfortunately, that ball just comes off of the Red Raven blockers there and out of bounds. So 9-8, lead back over to Fort Scott.
It's just been a back and forth game for this third set.
Yes, it has. And
a little trip.
Ooh, that's the thing about volleyball is you really have to have good communication, footwork, and whatnot, or you'll be running into players all the time. 9-9 score line. And we have Hammer and Hannah Armstrong back to serve.
Now, I like how they think that Hannah is just a spiker for Fort Scott, but then you see her serve, and you're just like, wow, she can play just about anywhere.
You're right. She can do a little bit of everything here. So let's see if she can work some of this magic.
And you can hear the fans down there just clapping for Hannah.
That's awesome to see them come back.
We need a little bit of loudness.
Yes, we do. Yes, we do.
Oh, good save by Hannah.
Yes.
Her length really helped her out in the long run.
And that is going to go over for a Red Raven point right there.
Almost hit the flag person over there.
Hannah Armstrong really had to use her full length to get to that one and her full wingspan as well.
Yeah.
But she was able to. And so here she is back to serve 10-9 Red Ravens.
Didn't have a little bit of luck on that one.
I think she went for power there, but failed with the placement. So that'll be 10-10. Score line even. Fort Scott serving. Number four, Bailey.
get hit by Kylie to find the find a spot where it, and number seven for Fort Scott thought it was going to go over, but it just did not.
Good block there from Soto and Bennett, I'm pretty sure, on that one, giving the Red Ravens the lead momentarily. Chloe Mills, number three, coming in to serve.
I feel like the net has the most blocks in all three sets so far,
yeah,
don't you think?
Seriously. Ball is up, and good block there.
Good hustle a little bit there by – oh, oh.
That was really good improvisation.
Oh, yeah. Way to communicate on that one.
Yeah. I mean, and honestly, that comes down to athleticism right there.
Yeah.
That was a broken play, more or less, but they made the most of it. So 12-10 to the Red Ravens. Starting to feel confident once again.
Slipped over onto the other side there, number five.
Point Red Ravens, 13-10, a little bit of momentum, and Fort Scott will try to stop this, and we will take a short break as well.
And we'll be right back for more CCC Volleyball right after this. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls of all ages, welcome back to CCC Volleyball here in Nellis Hall. I'm your announcer, Stephen Kyler. Alongside with me, the man, the myth, the legend, Dirk Andrews.
Now, unfortunately for that serve there, Chloe just unable to get it over. But, yeah, like I said earlier, happy to be here. It's a pleasure to be here. Exciting action. 1-1 so far, 13-11 in this third set, Red Ravens. Oh, Yeshka, nice hit there.
Never underestimate Yeshka because she has unbelievable power when it comes to spikes, and so does mainly most of their team. Like you'd never expect like Paola to ever spike it. I've seen her spike it before, and I was like, what?
And so Fort Scott filling themselves just a little bit here. Nice little two-point run. Bring it to 13-12. Red Ravens still lead, and that'll actually be 14-12 off of that errant serve. A host of substitutions coming in here. Styles will go back to serve.
The sister versus sister right now.
Will she go toward her sister?
She almost did.
We hadn't had it yet, huh?
Nope.
Number seven puts it up, and good dig there from Mills.
If Heather's sister, Casey, wasn't the LeBaron, I'd want to see her and Heather up in the front row.
Yeah.
Heather tried it. Paola tried to save it, diving into the swimming pool, but just barely misses the diving board.
Oh, man, yeah, that's really good hustle there. And, wow, what can you say? I mean, yeah, you know, we kind of joke around, but, boy, that hardwood is not too giving, mm-hmm. I imagine.
Yeah, because I played basketball in Caney for most of my high school career and junior high career. And believe me when I tell you this, that floor is hard.
It'll leave a mark. And so mm-hmm. Red Ravens, Soto. Dig there by Molina. Soto again, and there she has it. Very good. Point for the Red Ravens.
We have in the hammer.
All right. The
Hannah
hammer,
Armstrong.
Hannah Armstrong's back in as Molina will go back to serve. Third set, 15-13.
Yushka made a little tunnel there for the ball to go through her legs, and she just smiled, which is good positivity out there on the floor.
It's a soccer move there, huh?
Oh,
so
yeah.
So here we go. Ball's up.
Heather tried to recover that one, but it just went a little bit low.
A really good placement there by the Fort Scott hitter as 15-14. This set has certainly been like the others back and forth. So here we go. Ball is up.
Hit to Chloe Mills. Oh! You could literally hear the strike on that right there.
Oh, good hustle, good hustle.
Good hustle there, too, by Chloe Mills. Oh, okay.
And this will be a point to the Red Ravens. I think number two for Fort Scott ran into the net. So
Jasmine Okrafor.
We will take it where we can, especially a match like this. Yeshka Reyes will step back to, and last time we had a run, it was her serving. So let's see if we can have another run here.
Her serve is up and good. Hit to Heather's sister, Casey.
Ooh, almost blocked there. And
oh, Heather almost tried to gain that point there on her sister.
Almost had really good placement.
Just a little bit short.
So point will go over to the Greyhounds. It is 16-15. Red Ravens still lead. And that's going to go out there, an errant serve.
And almost hits an older gentleman over there.
He knows what to do with it, though.
Oh, yeah.
Nice job. Nice job. Very good.
Right on, dude.
And so we will have Bolick back to serve.
Hit to number three, set up by number 13, and hit over by number one, but blocked
right.
by Hannah.
There we go. There we go. Yeah, good ball movement from Fort Scott, but just better defense there from Coffeyville. 18-15, Coffeyville leads.
I think on the first set we had Kaylee Bowley with the serving and mainly getting the points.
Not much the Red Ravens can do right there. Just a good block and 16-18. Red Ravens still lead
by two in the third set. And this has been. What do you think of the game so far?
Oh, it's been exciting. Seriously, I mean it's anybody's game at this point.
Good thing in there by Casey to come out there to help the front line. Oh,
Kylie Dawson able to get a hand on it, just unable to block it completely. So 17-18, Red Ravens up by one.
When we played volleyball at my church camp and in high school for gym class, it was our hands were so red after that. And one time, I think my finger bent back on one of those on a block, and
I bet.
it hurt like something. So using that length for Zella Bennett. Kylie Dawson. Ooh, okay.
Will this one make it over? No, it will not. So good hustle pays off for the Red Ravens.
Yeah, but good hustle there by number 13 to get back over there in time and trying to hit it back over onto the other side.
Yes, it was. And so 19-17, Hannah Armstrong serves.
And that movie was pretty good too, 19-17.
Oh, just out of bounds there. Hannah's going to want that one back. She's upset with herself. So 19-18. Red Ravens still keep a lead. But like I said earlier, it's anybody's match, anybody's game.
And you have most of these kids in your class, don't you?
Yes, I do. I either have them currently or I've had them before. And so that kind of makes it even more special to come and watch.
Oh, yeah.
Ball goes up. Good job.
Set up by Paola and hit over by Kylie. Ooh.
Oh, good placement there.
Oh, almost broke one of the lights. Almost ran into one of her Casey Salz almost ran into one of her fellow members on the bench over there.
And good job overall by both squads.
Yeah.
But, you know, those unfortunate hits off the ceiling, off the lights, they can be really hard to play. 20-18, Chloe Mills steps up. Molina with the kill, or with the dig. Soto with the kill, but blocked by number one, Carly Smith, Aztec New Mexico. And so Fort Scott will take a timeout on the floor. We'll take a timeout as well.
Probably go do some suicides on the basketball floor, and we'll be right back after this for more of your CCC volleyball. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and I'm one of your announcers, Stephen Kyler. Alongside me is special guest announcer, the man, the myth, the legend, the one and only Dirk Andrews.
Great to be here. Great to be here. Chloe Mills puts up this serve.
Ooh, a little bit of a blocking contest.
And that is going to be point to the Red Ravens.
Almost knocked off one of the main speakers that's up on the roof here.
22-18. Three more points, and this set will be for the Red Ravens.
Oh, good reach there by Chloe Mills.
Great hustle there from her.
Good save by Kaylee. And hit over by Yishka.
Oh, there we go. Big block there. Geez.
Almost got tripped up there on the other side.
Huge block there. I think it was mostly Soto, but Bennett and Reyes there as well.
To back her up almost.
23-18 Red Ravens. They can taste the set victory here. Over to the Red Ravens dugout, up and over to Yashka. Yashka
finds a hole.
That's what I'm talking about, folks. 24-18.
Kill. If I do that anymore, my throat will be dry.
Yashka Reyes, sophomore. Chloe Mills, sophomore, looking to close this one out. Oh, and this one's going to be an unforced error that gives the Red Ravens the point and gives them the set as well. So Red Ravens lead two sets to one. We'll take a short break on the court and be right back with some more action.
I'm her favorite, but he's her favorite.
She likes him better than you?
Basically, yeah.
Oh, she said,
and then she just says bye to me all the time. Like, she talks to me on the phone when I was done with me. I'm like, wow, thanks, mom.
Here we are back at the campus of Coffeyville Community College looking to start the four sets, Stephen. Two for the Red Ravens, one for Fort Scott. The one that Fort Scott won was very convincing, though.
Yeah.
So even though we're up, I don't want to count them out just yet.
Yeah, because you could never count out any team at this point.
Good point.
Good. See the pun there? Point.
I didn't even mean it. I'm just a genius like that.
It was very punny indeed.
And so here we go. I think Fort Scott will start service for this match. We're going to work out the substitutions and high fives and all that good stuff.
All the woo!
Edmund Kansas, the 6th and 7th grade volleyball team.
Okay.
Oh, we got some young athletes here.
Sixth and seventh grade volleyball team. 6th and 7th grade volleyball team. I think from Labette.
I think that's at Edmund.
Oh, okay. You know, whenever you're a little kid, it's cool to, you know, come watch the big guys, right?
Yeah.
I remember being that age as Fort Scott gets it going here. This will be up, and Brianna. Oh, that hit the floor.
It looked like it hit the floor, but, like, they didn't say it hit the floor.
And we'll take their word for it. Hannah Armstrong. Thought it might have taken a touch, but it did not.
Ooh.
So 0-1. Fort Scott leading early in this fourth set.
And I'll just explain the rules for the fifth set here. If Fort Scott does win this set.
Ooh. There we go. There we go.
After that nice kill by Hannah Armstrong.
Yeah, that was a full extension right there. Mm-hmm. She reached all the way back for that one. But, yeah, go ahead with the rules there. So if we do go into a fifth set, what happens?
So in a fifth set of volleyball, both teams will go to 15. And whoever gets 15 wins. But if they're tied with like 14-14, then they'll still have to win by 2 points.
It's interesting. Very good. So
yeah.
Looking to maybe avoid all that together. Another point there from the Red Ravens. Yashka is serving. We have Armstrong, Dawson, and Bedour up front. Looks like we have Stiles and Molina in there as well. That one was a real tough ball for Heather to have to try to.
And her sister being a little cocky over there, going, woo!
Little sister, right? And so,
yeah.
Man, I'm sure the conversation after the match will be really interesting between the two as Bedour, she digs this one out. Hannah.
Man, like going up for a windmill dunk there.
Exactly.
You never see it coming.
Exactly. Nice block.
Just like that. You never seen that coming.
Yeah, and honestly, number two, Jasmine Okafor for Fort Scott, she's been a really good player for them, especially when she's close to the net. Really nothing the Red Raven players could do there. So 3-2, Fort Scott leads this fourth set.
I thought it was Coffeyville that was leading or something. Oh, no, you're right. It is Fort Scott. My bad.
All good, my friend.
I honestly can't count.
That's why you're here at CCC getting a quality education.
Yes, sir.
Good hustle all the way across court to Kylie Dawson.
Ooh, a little bit of height teamwork there.
And that's going to give the Red Ravens a point.
Oh, yeah.
Evening up this score 3-3. Hannah Armstrong in the middle. And like you said earlier, she averages 3.8 kills each set. And I think she's probably averaging even more today.
Yeah, and I think the one time I actually counted like spikes and kills for Hannah was I think she had a total of 20 kills.
Wow,
for five sets.
Wow, very good. So 4-3, Fort Scott leads by one. Number one, Carly Smith comes in.
6-foot freshman hailing from Aztec, New Mexico.
Long ways away.
It is.
Kylie, oh, wow.
Man.
When she gets moving forward like that,
yep.
When she gets that
there's
momentum.
No stopping.
No, there's almost really no stopping. And like you mentioned earlier, she's not that tall, but very athletic, able to jump. Wow. And she is
number 14.
Yeah, and she's just a freshman, so she'll
she'll
get even stronger and better.
Oh yeah,
coming back next year as Hannah Armstrong going to put this into service. 4-4 is the score line.
I've always said that when I was a senior in high school, I've always said that your senior year of sports is your most prime year, or like you've hit your peak, like a top.
Sure.
And now in college, you can increase it by just a little bit.
Keep on getting better, getting bigger, getting stronger as Kylie puts this one up. Hard to handle.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, really, really good play. And honestly, Steven, that reminds me of a play that happened earlier there. It was kind of a broken play, but Soto just with the awareness enough to get a fist to it and pat it into the floor. Chloe Mills going to step up to serve 5-5. So far in this third set.
You can hear the fans down there cheering, let's go Ravens, and let's go Ravens indeed. Oh, almost hit Brianna Chisholm over there.
Let's go Ravens indeed. You're exactly
right.
I love that. 6-5, Chloe Mills, let's keep this going. Let's see if we can find a groove here.
I don't know if much people know this, but when I went to Hidden Haven Christian Camp with my buddy John, we were 3-time volleyball champs.
So, folks, you are not just listening to an amateur here. You're listening to a pro. You're listening to a man that's won trophies.
We just won bragging rights and like free ice cream, but all in all, it was pretty good.
I think a lot of people might trade a trophy for some free ice cream.
But, oh, yeah.
We have Fort Scott making a little run here. They've evened the score up 6-6. Number 3, Bailey Morgan on the serve.
Yishka Reyes.
Wow, yeah, that was great placement on kill right there.
For all, hailing from Florida, Puerto Rico.
And so, you know, one time could be a fluke. Two times is a really cool thing, but three-time champions, I mean, you've basically cemented a dynasty there.
Yeah, we basically asserted our dominance on the court.
You are exactly right.
And we were also John and another guy, we were two-time basketball champ runner-ups.
Okay, as Nicole Soto kills that one there, 8-6. Red Ravens slowly taking the lead here. So, three-time volleyball champ, two-time basketball champ. It's a five-time winner right there.
I can't take all the credit. I got to thank some of my teammates too. I mean, they've all played a big part.
What a classy guy.
Yeah, I mean, look at Larry Bird, for example. He would have never gotten MVP if it wasn't for all of the players that helped him out with it.
And he had a lot of good players. As a tip off of a Red Raven player, this is going to make the score 8-7. Red Ravens still with the 1-point lead, but Fort Scott not going away easily.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, that serve was always going out right there. That's going to be 9-7 Red Ravens as Armstrong comes in. Molina goes back to serve.
And Soto is subbed out.
She did really good there in the middle while she was in. Tough one to handle there for Fort Scott. Oh, nice hustle for her to come up there. All right. Good
dive
kill
there.
Yeah, good hustle from Styles.
Oh, yeah.
Really good kill there from Brianna. She got up on that one. Good placement.
And we now have a timeout called here for Fort Scott, and I'll leave this for Dirk to say when we'll be back.
We're going to go down to the court. We're going to run probably 5 or 6 laps just real quick to keep us honest, and we'll be right back.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my Lord.
Hola, senores, senoritas. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. We are back here at Nell's Hall here for more CCC Volleyball. I'm Stephen Kyler, and with me is the man, the myth, the legend, the one and only Dirk Andrews on guest commentary.
You know, I could actually get used to an introduction like that. If you want to come to all my classes and just introduce me before class like that, that would actually be great.
We could give you a cool, entrance song
and
a fog machine and all
that.
I
would love that. I would love that, actually. As
make
Yishka.
You seem like Darth Vader almost.
Yeah. Oh, good placement there. Both teams really playing hard. Okafor puts this one over. Molina digs. Good back and forth here.
Good hustle, though, too, by
Paola.
And good trick by Heather Stiles, tricking out her sister like that.
You know, if it wasn't her sister, she might get called for, a penalty. But, you know, sisterly love there. It's all good.
Oh, you can see her. You can see her going, that's my sister, all right.
That's hilarious. Okay, so 11-7, Red Ravens lead this one on the journey to 25.
Number 7 with a spike and hit the Paola, but almost hits some fans down there.
Hey, number 7, Addison Lyons, she's actually from Fort Scott. She did a really good job there placing that ball, putting it where basically no Red Raven could get to.
Oh, yeah.
Addison Lyons, 5'11", sophomore out of Fort Scott, Kansas.
And I have a buddy of mine, Jay Scott, playing their basketball up there at Fort Scott Community College.
All right, good luck to him. You'll be seeing him this season then.
Yep, November 1st, their first game.
Oh, they play Fort Scott November 1st?
Yep, the first game.
Awesome. I'm looking forward to that. So, yeah, Red Raven basketball. And, hey, guys, KUSN 98.1, that's where you turn in to find all the action.
Yes, sir. And who knows, you might be able to hear me on there.
What a blessing that would be.
I know, right? Oh, good play there by Hannah Armstrong to find the open spot.
The hammer, Hannah Armstrong, yep, with that one there, makes the score 12-8. Red Raven's going to look to build this lead with Yeshka serving.
Oh, yeah. With only a four-point lead, though, who knows? Fort Scott could make a comeback.
And oh, it's been that type of match.
Oh, yeah. You could hear the fans just cheering it. Oh, but the serve is just a little bit too much power there for Yeshka.
Going for that back corner there. Almost had it. And once again, number 7, Addison Lyon. She's going to step up to serve for Fort Scott.
It's Yeshka. Set up by Heather and Spike Libriano.
All right.
Good. See, I'm telling you, that's why Heather is leading in assists with 5.28, almost 5.3.
And, you know, a setter who can put it in the right spot makes the killer or striker, whatever it is,
yeah,
it makes their job easier by putting it in a really good place. Yep. Number 4, Kaylee Bolick.
I almost thought that was Heather there, and she thought she served it to her sister. I was like, oh, that's cool. Because I bet whenever they were little, they would be playing in the backyard.
Oh, I bet, yeah.
Or like me and my family, we played a little volleyball in the pool.
Good placement. Ooh, there. Back and forth as we go. Ooh, that's in.
Inbounds for Kylie. Ooh, Dawson. That's her fourth kill, I think.
Good placement there. Hey, yeah, so can you imagine the style household, basketball, ooh, volleyball,
soccer,
softball, maybe soccer. Yeah, I bet they're very competitive. But a lot of love, I'm sure, between the two as well.
I wonder if they have a favorite parent or if or if the parent prefers a Fort Scott or Coffeyville.
Oh, that would be tough for them, yeah. So, like, maybe one wore Fort Scott, one wore Coffeyville. Yeah, that would be tough for sure.
Luckily for me, my mom is the only one that takes care of me, and since my dad passed away, and I am an only child, which means that she's been at my corner this entire time.
Awesome job there.
I'm surprised she's put up with my crap for all this time.
She's put up with you for this long. I think she can maybe survive a couple more years.
Yeah.
As Hammer and Hannah went ahead and hammered that one down, giving the Red Ravens a 15-10 lead. And I guess there's going to be a timeout on the floor.
And we'll be right back for more Red Ravens volleyball right after this. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls of all ages, we are back live here in Nellis Hall, home of the Red Ravens. I am here, Stephen Kyler. I am here, and with me is for right now, the man, the myth, the legend, the one and only, the cream of the crop, Dirk Andrews.
Cream of the crop now. So I paid him to actually say that, folks.
Yeah.
I really appreciate that. That's money well spent.
Yes, sir.
15-10, Hannah Armstrong serving.
It looked like we had
I think we had some movement, or you know, someone in a particular position that they were not supposed to be in. But either way, we will take that point, and it will make it 16-10.
Looks like we had have a little miscommunication there too by for the official over there by the scoreboard side, and now the head official over here is talking with I think that might be the captain.
Yeah, it must be. I imagine he probably communicates with the team captains. And nonetheless, though, 16-10, 9 more points for the Red Ravens.
Yep. Oh.
almost made it over.
Oh yeah. Now it would have been hilarious to see Casey Styles and Heather Styles as team captains.
Yeah, that would be pretty cool actually. Yeah.
Because I don't know which one of them would have been considered like the better half of the two, but who knows? I think honestly, this is just my personal opinion. I think they both are pretty good players.
Oh, they're both really good players, no doubt about that. They impact their team. Another discussion here with the head referee. So 16-11 score line. We are in the fourth set. Red Ravens lead 2-1 so far. So Steven, how are your classes going? You passing all your classes?
Well, I haven't been kicked out yet. So far they're good.
Yeah, that is a good sign. That is a good sign. If you hadn't been kicked out yet,
I wouldn't have got to do this with you.
That's true. But you know, on the CCC campus, as crazy as it sounds, we actually only have about 3 weeks left.
Time flies by.
It does. It flies when you're having fun. It flies when you're busy. You know, you've been doing these games.
Yeah, I've even been doing some soccer with you, which is pretty fun.
Soccer.
Learning some new words and like be a Benito or or like learning the positions.
Yeah,
and
yeah. Hey, and you know, I have
just
to admit,
having fun.
Yeah, you're right. And I have to admit, just like you're learning with soccer, man. I come here and I'm learning quite a bit tonight as well. But yeah, so we are almost done with the fall semester. Here at CCC, last day of finals is November 19th. So it's actually really cool that we end so early because it gives the students a chance to go home for Thanksgiving and not have to worry about getting back. And for some of our students who are from a long ways away, they always had to kind of weigh out their options. Do I go home for Thanksgiving? Do I stay? Because after Thanksgiving, we have like 2 weeks left. But, not anymore. We're going to go ahead and get out a little early.
Yeah.
Allows students to travel.
And we also are out during Christmas. Did you know that? We're also out during Christmas.
Oh, well, yeah. I mean.
Feliz Navidad, indeed.
Sure. November 19th, the last day, and I think January, the first or second week of January is when we come back. So a lot of students who come from high school to college, it's their first year, they're like, whoa, we get that long of a break? Yes, we do. And teachers, faculty, administration and students alike all really enjoy that very long break during the winter. So I think that the referees are still trying to figure out exactly what happened on that call.
It looks like it's going to be CCC's ball now, actually, by the looks of it.
Yeah, still 16-11.
It looks like they're just going to replay that.
Little action from the CCC crowd.
Oh, yeah. We are here at Nellis Hall again, and so far it looks like we have a pretty good crowd here tonight.
Yeah.
And I'm counting over too many people to count, and you even have some soccer players here watching, some fellow students. I think some of my fellow classmates are here too.
Awesome. Yeah, we have some parents. We have aunts, uncles here for sophomore night.
Yeah. Yeah, we even have a little kids squad here all the way from Edmond, a little 6th and 7th grade volleyball team, which is always good to see the youth come out and watch a college game, because I've been trying to get my cousin Callie to come watch a CCC volleyball game for a little bit, and she's like, I don't know. But
well, I guarantee if she came and watched one set, she would want to come and watch some more, that's for sure.
Especially if I let her come up here in the press box.
Yeah.
She would really love that because then she'd get a full view of it.
Yeah, up here in the press box is very enjoyable, a lot of fun.
Yep.
And I think we're going to go ahead and play a game here. So all confusion has been put to rest. Hannah Armstrong up for this serve. Good dig there from Fort Scott.
Way to stay into the game by number 13 as well. And Zella Bennett with her first kill of the game. Good attempted block there by the Fort Scott Greyhounds, but didn't work out well for them.
Yeah, was able to get a hand or a fist to it, but just was not able to place it back over the net. So Hannah Armstrong will serve once again, 16-10, Red Ravens lead. looking to close this one out.
Good save there by Casey Stiles. Just goes into the net. It almost looked like Nicole almost ran into the net there, but it luckily she managed to keep herself back a little.
Yeah, good job by her. And, you know, if the ball did make it over, she was going to pound it back over the net right there. 17-10. Armstrong. Oh, there we go. Gets an ace.
Yes, sir.
ACE ace for Hammer and Hannah Armstrong.
The fans now are getting a little bit more pumped up and a little more energetic, which is what we love to see here.
We love it, yeah. 18-10, Red Ravens lead.
Oh, yeah. If you don't hear that, ladies and gentlemen, then you are not watching CCC volleyball.
Good block. Oh, good dig.
Good recovery. And good communication, too, for CCC to find the right spot, but even better playing there by number four to find the open spot. That number four would be Brittley Bailey.
And, you know, she's left-handed, so for defenders it's a little bit different trying to defend her shots.
Yeah, because when I played, I'm usually right-handed. But, like, seeing left-handed players, it totally changes everything.
You're right. You're
then
right.
You have to go to a different angle.
Exactly. So I imagine it's the same in volleyball. And so she's having a lot of success today. 18-11, Red Ravens still hold a lead, though.
Good block there by Fort Scott, but really good work there by Nicole to try to find the open spot there. But
almost.
And number three there found the open spot, though, for Fort Scott and making it now 18-12 here in the fourth set.
Kylie Dawson tried to lay out for that one just short. Brittley Bailey for Fort Scott.
A little bit of judgment there on that one.
Yeah, that would be tough to handle right there because it looks like it's going to be in, but yet it's still traveling above your waist, and so the hand placement is interesting.
Like that right there.
Another one. Yeah. Another one.
Oh, she
right
did
there.
A little heel kick right there. A little zippity-doo-dah.
And so the Red Ravens will try to stop this momentum just a little bit with the timeout. We'll be right back with some more CCC action.
Right after this, so don't go away. Guess what? We are back and live here, ladies and gentlemen, here at Nellis Hall. I'm your announcer, Stephen Kyler. Alongside me is the man, the myth, the legend, Dirk Andrews. So what do you teach, actually, at CCC?
It's a very good question, man. I do public speaking. I do mass communication. I do humanities, which is just like culture, things like that.
We had that in high school a little bit, too, for mainly like high school like history classes and all that. I found them very fun to watch, especially whenever we could, like, whenever they'd actually come to our school and come into the auditorium. But then whenever it came, like, went to be online, it just got a little boring.
Well, so what's interesting about what you're saying there is Caney and Coffeyville, and that ball's out. That'll be Red Raven point. Caney and Coffeyville actually we get the same performers.
Yeah.
So the performers that you were getting at Caney High School, we were also getting here at CCC. And, yeah, you might get some sword swallowers. You might get some jugglers. You might get some folk music. You never quite know. But
some storytelling.
Yeah, so that class is a lot of fun, to be quite honest with you.
I kind of find the storytelling a little fun because, like, you get to hear cool stories about that all that stuff. And,
and
a point there for Red Ravens, making it now 20-14.
And so we are creeping closer to that 25-point mark. Reyes, Soto, Bennett, Molina.
And Mills. Or did you already count Mills?
No, I did not. And Bolig as well. Good job. Way to back me up there, partner.
So how is Ryan Butcher doing? Is he ready for soccer?
I hope he is. As we see a nice kill here from Fort Scott, I hope Ryan Butcher's ready for soccer because you know what? Soccer here at CCC Men's and Women's will actually have a first-round playoff game here in Coffeyville next Wednesday.
Is it a home game or is it away?
Yes, it is, sir. It'll be a home game.
And who do we play? Because I know we'd be playing some pretty good teams whenever I've been announcing, which was only twice.
I'm not sure who we play, actually. I'll have to look into that as – but it will be another playoff team, so it will be another quality team overall.
it's always like so hard to figure out like each team's strategy as to where they like find positions to play at.
Oh,
never
there we go,
never go up against that. I mean, 6 feet, 6 foot tall Nicole Soto blocks number one Carly Smith, who's also 6 foot tall, freshman from Aztec, New Mexico.
That was like a real just straight up battle yeah. right there. Nicole won that one as Styles back to serve. Oh, good hit there, but good dig as well.
Nicole Soto tried to spike it over, but just hits the net. The net, I think, has the most blocks so far in the entire sets of volleyball.
Yeah, and, you know, not exactly a bad hit, but yet just the placement just yeah. a little bit off there. As Styles, the other Styles, as we've yeah. been calling her, she'll be serving for Scott. 21-16, Red Ravens still in the lead here. Mills digs this one out. Soto.
Oh, good block there by both number 7 and number 2 as well.
They will make this. Yeah, they'll make this a match here. They're gonna.
Oh, it looked like Brianna Bedore stepped over onto the other side. Yeah. She didn't like that call, but hey, you can't argue with the refs unless you want to get pulled out of the game.
That's true. Doesn't do you any good there. Good observation there too. I was wondering what had happened, but. So 17-21, Red Ravens lead. Styles with the serve.
Fort Scott actually kind of making a little comeback here.
Yes, they are.
Oh, good play there. Ooh,
oh, wow. That is
smart. That was a smart play by the Greyhounds.
Yes, it was. What good placement, too.
And wow. Brianna down there just like, it's okay. We're good. We're still in the lead.
One of those sophomores, right?
Yeah, sophomore leadership.
So here we go, 18-21. Fort Scott on a run here.
Oh, yeah.
There we go. There
Nicole
we go.
Soto finding the open spot in that corner. Soto. And it is very good. She really knows where to pick the targets at. And even Anna Armstrong does, too.
Yeah, and you would think it'd be all about speed. But, you know, placement plays a big part in that as well. Mm-hmm. So here we have Paola Molina. She's going to go ahead and serve this up. 22-18, Red Raven lead, looking to close this one out.
How long have you been teaching here at CCC? About, I'm going to guess, 5 years?
Oh, this is my ninth year, actually.
Ninth year. Mm-hmm. I was only four off.
Good job there by our Styles. Yashka just had to get that one over.
Oh, pulled a play out of Hannah Armstrong's book there, going over to the other side and just
true.
Spiking it down,
yeah,
making it 22-19.
So Jasmine Okafor, she's actually, yes, she's pretty athletic. She's athletic
yeah.
enough to pull that one off.
I think she
or was that has, number, was that Claudia number 5 might have been?
Not no, I think sure, that might have, either Claudia or Jasmine.
True. Those two are very good players.
Yeah.
Fort Scott serves 22-19.
Hannah Armstrong hitting it over, but successfully recovered.
There we go. Nice block.
Number two. Oh, Paola did not want to get her hands up for that one. I wouldn't either. That ball was coming at me at 80 miles an hour.
And it looked like it might have been going out, but stayed
yeah.
in. So really good job by Fort Scott to place that ball exactly where it needed to be.
And you can hear the fans down there. They are not agreeing with that call. But
yeah, you're right. I saw some
the fans, but the referee's decision is final.
You are exactly right about that. Oh, good one.
Oh, 21-22 here.
This one's brewing, folks, as there will be a timeout called on the floor. 22-21. Fort Scott making a run. Let's give a couple of seconds and we'll take a break ourselves.
And we'll be right back for more CCC volleyball right after this, so don't go away. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls of all ages, welcome back here to CCC Volleyball here in Nellis Hall. I am here alongside with Dirk Andrews. I am the one and only Stephen Kyler, as well as the one and only Dirk Andrews.
Hey.
Can't count you out there on that one. Oh.
And that's just going to go out there. And so – what our listeners don't realize is I actually paid a lot of money for all the compliments that I'm getting tonight. So,
and every compliment is worth every single penny of that, Dirk.
It's been well worth it for sure. Here's Yesh Gureyes, 23-21. Two more points, and the Red Ravens will take this match.
And just a little recap on the fifth set scoring and all that mumbo jumbo is like if both teams are tied with two wins for four sets, then it will go to the fifth set, which means that the captains will have the referee flip a coin, and whoever gets it will then go to be they'll have to only score by 15 in the fifth set.
We might not get that far, Steven.
Oh, yeah.
Here we go, 24-21. The crowd senses it.
They're on their feet, and so are we as well. And Dirk Andrews here is cheering them on as well from up here in the crow's nest.
Here we go. That's going to be a tough ball.
Oh, yep.
And that's it, folks.
Game, set, match.
That is it, folks. So for all of us here up here in the booth, for the sophomores down there on the court, for all the students, the moms, the dads, the aunts, the uncles,
the grandparents,
everybody.
And their pets.
It's been a privilege being up here, man. It's been a privilege. I really appreciate it. All of you folks, I hope you have a good night. Be safe. Be smart. And, you know, always look to KUSN 98.1 for all of your Red Raven athletic action.
And I'd like to also give a special shout-out to the Fort Scott team for playing their hearts out and giving a really good game. And I'd like to thank you, Dirk, for agreeing to come up here and getting all those compliments.
Well, you know, they had to pay me a lot of money to be up here.
Yeah,
but
it's
money well spent,
He's a premium guy.
But really, it has been a pleasure, folks. And congratulations to the sophomores overall. Thank you very much. I'll let you close this one out.
And ladies and gentlemen, you may now go to the refrigerator, get your snacks, and sit down and relax, because we are done here at Nellis Hall for of your CCC Volleyball. Thank you and good night.
Peace.